here with Years of Years, and it's This Day in Disney for September 2nd. And to start off, we're talking about William Norman Ferguson. He was born this day in 1902, and he was an animator at the Walt Disney Studios and really a central contributor to the studio's stylistic development of the 1930s. So he was most noted as the creator of Pluto. He also is credited for developing Peg Leg Pete and the Big Bad Wolf. He was the primary animator of the Witch and the Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. So that's really interesting. I know there's a lot of fans of the Witch and Snow White. And starting as a cameraman, he switched, so he started off as a cameraman in 1929, but he switched to animation really quickly and he rose rapidly as an animator. He actually was a very hard worker. He worked, quote, rough and loose with the focus on feeling and action and character's personality, and rather than the detail and structural of formal draftsmanship. So his animation style was, you know, not super structured, but it really gave a lot of feeling. He produced a high volume of work, 18 feet a week. The average was 10 feet a week, and that's based on the film footage is 16 frames, so very interesting. He served as a sequence director, animator for many Disney classics and Walt Disney features. So he ended up suffering from diabetes. He left the Walt Disney Studios because of his health issues in 1953. And he actually did pass away of a heart attack in 1957, so that made him only 55 years old. So that part is very sad because he was highly talented, very hard worker. Just going through his filmography, he worked on so many films, and you know, like I said in the beginning, he was a big contributor to the style and development of Disney in the 30s. So that was really important and really the beginning of Walt Disney Studios. So it's really, he had a huge impact. He received a Winsor McCay Award in 1987. And was inducted as a Disney legend, which he well deserved, in 1999. So that's Norm Ferguson, really cool Disney legend who did so much for the Walt Disney Studios. And then also on this day in 2004, this was so interesting to find out, Echoes of Africa opened the American Adventure Pavilion in the American Heritage Gallery. So that's the American Pavilion, the big building, and you can go in there. We've actually seen other things in the gallery before, but this was back in 2004. So this was the Echoes of Africa, and it was the Disney Tishman African Art Collection. So the Tishmans were a really cool couple. They collected tons of art. Over 25 years, they collected 525 pieces of African art. And they actually, Paul and Ruth Tishman had gathered it, and at the point in 84, or 83, 84, they donated it to the Disney company because all this collection was going to be in the Epcot Pavilion, the African Pavilion, which was, you know, slated to be built at that time. Unfortunately, that did not happen due to different sponsorship issues from, you know, different countries in Africa, and it just didn't come quite together. Actually though, it's one of the few pavilions that never happened that actually they had a lot they had already done for it. In fact, when you go to Epcot and you pass the outpost, the Africa outpost, that was actually built to just be like a temporary, you know, exciting area to let you know that the Africa, it was actually called, going to be called the Equilateral Africa Pavilion. So people were getting excited about that with this outpost, and now the outpost has just stayed. So too bad about that. And this collection would have been in a gallery in the pavilion. And so Disney did use the collection as research pre-production for The Lion King. So the collection, the art, is in The Lion King. So I really loved learning about that. And in 2015, after this gallery showing in 2004, the entire collection was donated to the Smithsonian Institute. And it's part of the National Museum of African Art now. So you can see it over there at the Smithsonian. And like I said, sad news, we never got the Equilateral Africa Pavilion. I was super disappointed to hear that this was almost like, it was almost there. And so maybe they'll do it in the future. I would be really happy to have an Africa Pavilion. I mean, it's a huge continent. It should have its own pavilion, right? There's a lot of debates on Disney pavilions, and there were supposed to be two others, the Israel Pavilion and the Spain Pavilion as well. Those were the three that really they put a lot of effort into to doing. You know, they actually had graphics for them and everything. But there's tons of other pavilion ideas out there. And I know that Disney is always kind of talking about having, you know, new stuff, new pavilions. And, you know, right now a lot of things are on hold, so I'm not really sure about all that. But anyway, I thought this was interesting. You can try and go look online at this Tishman or Disney Tishman collection. It's really interesting. And go look at Norm Ferguson's filmography. You can find that online as well. All that he was involved in, especially like the leadership roles that he took. And he had a big influence on the Disney company. So that's it for this day in Disney. I hope you have a great day.